Okay, let's go into how Dotenvx works. I have an app here, which is requiring .env, and it's outputting hello world. I can run that, and just like that, it says hello world. To use Dotenvx, it's as easy as just replacing .env with Dotenvx. Let's come in here. Let's swap .env for at .env(x). .env(x). And there you go, just like that, it still says hello world. Now we can take things a step further. We could install curl. Excuse me, we could install .env(x) via curl. And just like that, now we can actually run it this way. So we can remove .env(x) from the require. And if I run that, it's going to say hello undefined. But I can do .env(x) dash dash run node index.js and I get hello world. So from there, the next thing we can do is we can create a different environment. So let's do hello production. And now I can do .env(x) run the dash f flag for file and do node index.js. And there you go, you're getting hello production. And then the final thing you can do with .env(x) is you can actually encrypt that. So let's run encrypt. And now we have our .env public key and we have hello and it's encrypted. And inside our .env keys file, we have the private key that's used to decrypt this. And now I can run .env(x) run and that will actually decrypt that value just in time using that private key in the .env keys file and then actually inject the correct decrypted variable just in time. So that is how .env(x) works.